and let guys do final squats. We had Sasha, right? Personal injury, let guys do final squats, just go out of Georgia. And I'm here today to talk to you a little bit about what does an attorney or a lawyer or an insurance adjuster need in your marriage when you're as a doctor like to marry. Under Georgia law, yes, can be right to a judge. There are certain requirements, and based on what the requirements are, first of all, it's going to be what your layman's terms. So I know that you've gone to medical school or chiropractic school, and you like to counsel your language and medical terms that a jury will understand. So, first of all, keep it simple, stupid, the kiss method. When a lawyer looks at a narrative, he's looking at a narrative that he can read to the jury without putting in the score. It's got to be less than 3 pages. When you write your narrative, if you're going to use medical terms such as cervical or lumbar, you're going to have to put in brackets after it in layman's terms what that means, because some people sitting in a jury box that haven't been to medical school. So if you write cervical, you have to bracket, back, bracket, lumbar, bracket, back, bracket. So when I read it to the jury, they can understand it. What an attorney's looking for in an NMM is basically just certain topics that you need to hit that will give you most knowledge, you know, with the patient and the evaluation of the claim. What are you looking for? History, patient's complaints, examinations and findings, diagnosis, statement, prognosis, permanency, and any future estimated costs for future care. When you write your narrative, please break it down into those paragraphs and keep it very simple. The most important thing that an attorney and an insurance adjuster is looking for in the narrative is whether or not you say that the trauma was so bad that the person's condition or injury is permanent in nature. That's the most important thing. Now, I know that you believe that, you know, you must, in order for you to say that it's permanent, it's got to be proven to an absolute certainty. But the law doesn't look at it that way. The law says you use a balancing act. Is it more likely than that that this person's condition is going to be permanent? Nobody has a crystal ball. But if you know that based on your knowledge and experience and having handled similar cases in the past, that it is more likely than not that the condition is going to be permanent, you are doing your patient a disfavor if you are not putting that in your narrative. The reason is that if it's permanent, and you say that based on your knowledge, experience, and training that it's a permanent condition, I as an attorney can make a lifetime argument. So, what the life table I can do is, for instance, if a person, a male, is 27 years old, the life table will say that that person will live approximately so many more years of life on an average. Doesn't mean he's going to live that many years and then die. It just means that on an average, a male 27 will live this many more years. I can take that life table, if you say it's permanent, and I can ask for instance, an hour a day at minimum wage, times 365 days a year, times just life expectancy of whatever that figure is on the table, and I can write a figure on the board for the jury to consider that it's permanent condition. The next paragraph is, if you say that it's permanent in nature, then go to the next step. Obviously, if it's permanent, then it's going to need future care. If you need future care, do not this permanent, say you've got an experience of exacerbation, maybe he's working in the yard and he flares up this condition, you need to say that during periods of exacerbation, he's going to need required future care to get him back under control or let's say 5 or 10 visits a year at an approximate cost of $500 per year. Again, I take that $500 per year that's being guesstimated. I can apply it to the life table, multiply it out, write another figure on the board for the jury to consider. So that's basically what the principal things are that an attorney is looking for. He's looking for you to keep it simple, keep it short, use layman's terms, say it's permanent if it's permanent, and if it is permanent, give me something that I can work with for future medical care. And remember, your patient is going to be hearing this being read to the jury. They're going to read it themselves. And it educates them, too, that they need to allow enough money out of their settlement to come back to you when they need it. Again, I appreciate you listening to this tape. If you're moving forward from Asia, if you have any patients that are looking for a trial,